Salut, everyone. You haven't heard that in quite some time, have you? Welcome to another Apartments Peopled. I was very excited to do another one of these. And then, just this week, I got a question on Tumblr that was like... It's not actually a question. But someone on Tumblr was like, well, I would love to see you build some more apartments. And I got so excited. I never want to spoil my bulls. Like, every time I post a sneak peek on Tumblr, I'm like, does this show too much? Do I want them to know what I'm doing? Is it gonna ruin the surprise? Is anyone even gonna want to watch it if they've already seen one tiny sneak peek? But yeah, that just got me so excited that I had to share a picture. So you might have seen a tiny part of the dining room already, but I hope you're still just as excited as I am to watch this. So if you hadn't guessed it from this view right here and the title, this is a French apartment built. It is supposed to be in Paris, so naturally I've used a lot of Felix's Paris set, which makes this feel so incredibly luxurious and elegant, and I simply love it. And you might be wondering, what the hell happened to the windows that are usually in this apartment? This is 122 Hakim House, if you would like to place this, but if you would like to place it, you might also have to change the windows. So I didn't do that in my last apartment build because I'm pretty sure it doesn't transfer to the gallery. So it's so easy. It's honestly incredibly easy. I've done it for the first time for this apartment, and I'm gonna link a video tutorial that explains the full process. It's honestly, it's so easy. As long as you have the tool mod, and the tool mod is so useful anyways, like I would not wanna build without it anymore. So as long as you have the tool mod, it's incredibly easy. You just have to follow that very nice tutorial. It's actually quite self-explanatory. You know, you can't delete the apartment windows because they're not part of the editable space. But with the tool mod, you can still select them, just move them towards you by just clicking the ground somewhere in the interior space of the apartment, and then they are in the editable space and you can just delete them. So that's how you get rid of the old windows. And then you can just draw a wall one tile away from the actual exterior wall. I found this easiest after doing the floor plan. So you like exactly know how wide your wall is and then have it span the entirety of the wall where the windows are supposed to go. So for example, in this living room right here, I would have it span four tiles. So it would mimic the exterior wall, but just one tile in. And then I would just place the windows or doors or whatever I wanted, the balcony as well, for example, on that new wall. And then I would just select all the objects, which are then basically in perfect relation to each other, and turn on the grid and move it onto the wall by just clicking in the middle of the old wall, and then they move there and they have the cutout. And sometimes a few of Felix's older windows are placed in the grid in kind of a weird way. So then sometimes I'd use the tool mod on those to elevate them a little or fix their position. And it was honestly so easy. You can definitely do it. The tutorial explains it way, way better than I just did. And I'm gonna link that in the description. So if you are planning on downloading this apartment, don't be dismayed, it's absolutely possible and not even hard. I'm not entirely sure how many of the windows you're gonna get with the gallery download, because for some reason some of them show up in the gallery preview. So I'm not too sure if some are gonna find their way into this apartment when you download, but if they don't, the open doors in the living room and the bedroom and the primary bathroom are the open interior doors from Felix's Paris set, and the tall, smaller windows are from the Georgian set. But enough technical chit-chat, because this apartment is something I've wanted to do for quite some time, and I'm sure something you expected from me. I wanted to, and I do think I succeeded in building the most typical Paris apartment that one could think of. It is bright, it has beautiful old architectural features, it has a herringbone wood parquet that I made from the Vampire's Diagonal wood flooring, and it has lots of cream neutral colors and then a few bright blue, or I guess definitely blue color accents, and it came very naturally to me. I feel like it looks exceptionally elegant, which I'm gonna have to mostly credit to Felix's and Harry's beautiful custom content. But yeah, I felt like it made this apartment feel bigger somehow, and I was a little worried that it might feel stiff with all this elegance, but I don't think it does. I do still feel like I'd be particularly careful walking through all these spaces and potentially a little apprehensive about moving through this apartment and trying not to walk into all the beautiful vases and stuff. But I do think it still feels homey and lively, and as if I would want to spend lots of time in this apartment. I think this initial fear would probably disappear after spending a few hours here. And to make sure of that, I have put some effort into making everything look not entirely perfect. So I wanted it to look well designed and cared for, but I've put everything that made sense at a slight angle, and I've left a notebook lying around, and I love these cookbooks that came with the cool kitchen stuff pack, which I've used in this build. I haven't done that so much recently, although I really, really love them, because I do find myself trying to not use too many new packs that I haven't already used on the exterior. Like, sometimes I do let loose entirely, as with the old shipyard, for example, or Georgiebury Manor. But generally, I notice myself being very conscious about what packs I use. You know what? No one has asked me to do that, ever. So I'm not really certain why I do that, but I do think Cool Kitchen has a few very nice objects, and I love those books. They feel very real, and I appreciate that, and I loved putting them in this build. They compensate for the marble flooring and the marble countertops and the huge marble kitchen that I'm gonna put in a second, and make this more of a home. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering about that plaque on the wall to the left, It's also one of those things in the apartment that you can't delete. It's a historical sign, or whatever they call it. And so I actually didn't want to delete those because I kind of like them and I felt like they make sense for a Parisian apartment. So I've just moved them to spaces that made sense for me and where I could make a feature out of them instead of trying to hide them somewhere. And now they give this apartment a deeper backstory, which I really appreciate. And they fit with the color theme, so advantages only. Wow, I've been furnishing this kitchen for a long, long time. But I guess that is at least in part due to the custom pantry, which I thought was very French. Go ahead and try and tell me that it doesn't look as if it should have some very delicate pastries in it at all times. Regia Sims are gonna have to enjoy all on their own, by the way, because this only has one bedroom, but quite a big one, and another custom closet, which one might argue is more important than a kid's bedroom or a guest bedroom. Oh, this is the point where it's not yet, but soon will come a point where I realize that this is another kitchen where I've forgotten to put a fridge. I don't know what it is about fridges that makes them so volatile. This is another kitchen that I use the kitchen for. I've done that so much lately. I really, really still appreciate that pack. It's just so timeless. And I also love the kitchen that came with the Paris set, and the marble kitchen from the Paris set would have gone great with this build, but I wanted it to be a touch more modern, to feel a little more accessible with all this in-your-face elegance, you know? Oh, this office that I'm doing right now might just be my favorite office that I've ever done. I was so happy I got to use that modern sofa in this blue colorway. It's so pretty, and I've only ever used this sofa in very neutral swatches. Maybe only black and white, and it works so well in this room, and I'm really glad I got to make it work. It's a beautiful color, but putting a brightly colored sofa in any interior is always kind of experimental, and I'm glad I found the courage to do it for this build, because I do think it lifts this office to another level. Also, great opportunity to use the spa day shelves, which might just be my favorite shelves, and they're not even custom content. Spa day is one of my most used stuff packs anyway, with Dine Out and Vampires, probably. If I had to recommend stuff packs, it would probably be those three. And Jungle Adventure. Jungle Adventure is so good. I would honestly even buy that if it was just the build items. They're glorious, I tell ya. Also, I found this. I say I found this. That's ridiculous. I looked through the catalog for the very first time and I noticed this desk chair that came with Get to Work, which is the oldest expansion pack, so everyone except me knows about this desk chair, and it's beautiful. I can't believe I never saw that before. But I think I didn't really look into the desk chair category, because that is just something that I would not have expected good design from the Sims team. But I was wrong, and I'm very happy I was wrong, and I do apologize. I also feel like Get to Work is an underrated pack. Maybe it's not at all Maybe it's just me. I can definitely say I underrated that pack, but I have come to my senses and now I really appreciate it. We've moved on onto the custom wardrobe that I was talking about earlier. This took forever to do. I really should have cluttered the shelves step by step, but instead I laid out all the shelves and then I had to move them all back out individually time and time again because the objects would just snap to shelves beneath or above the ones that I actually wanted to clutter, and it was unbearable. I would love to know what you think about the light switches and power outlets that came with Felixandra's Berlin set. They are not something I particularly wanted or care about, but I used them, not the power outlets, but I did put in light switches into this build. And as I said, I would love to know what you think, if you care for that realism. I made sure that the light switches make sense. So for example, the one that is on the left of the screen right now is for the closet lights, which I haven't done yet, but I'm gonna do. And then I've also put them throughout the rest of the apartment wherever they made sense. And I still feel the same way. I don't particularly care for them, but I would love to have my mind changed by you if that's something you have an opinion about. I can see myself putting these in more builds or in future builds in general. I do not see myself using the power outlets too much because that is something that I usually try to hide in real life and something I don't like aesthetically. But the light switches are nice. I mean, the power outlets that Felix made are obviously the nicest power outlets that anyone could ever have. But I'd still rather live my life without any power outlets at all. And if The Sims gives me that opportunity, then I think I'll take it. But yeah, I would love to know your opinion on all of that. And it seems like we are finally done with the cluttering of this closet, which can only mean that it is now time for the rest of the bedroom and the ensuite, which I particularly enjoyed because of the open doors. Those really transform any build so much. I love using them. I'm so happy that Harry's new spoon set includes a window that has an opened and a closed version. That's epic. I've wanted that for so long, and I'm so looking forward to using that in a modern build. That's gonna be so nice. I wish every window came with an open version, or there was just a setting on the window where you could choose if it was supposed to be open or closed. That would change my life. But these doors are really doing it for me, and I would advise you to not look at this apartment from the exterior because, how do I say this? It's ugly. It's really hideous. That's something the tool mod can change, and it looks kind of weird, like the windows look a little glitchy from the exterior, but I thought it really didn't matter because who looks at their apartment building from the exterior? You never will, or at least I won't. So now that I've tried changing the apartment windows and doors to whatever windows and doors I want for my specific vision of a build, I can definitely see myself doing that more in the future, which will lead me to build more apartments. So I hope that's something you want as well, as I get asked about apartments quite a lot. And I've always felt like the Max's windows were kind of in the way of me really enjoying the apartments. Now, another thing that the Tuomaud cannot fix is that the apartments have a set ceiling height, and you will never, ever find me building in an apartment that has short walls. That just goes against every fiber of my being. But I hope you enjoyed this build, and I hope you feel like you just spend 20 minutes in Paris today. If you missed the video tour in my last build, the old shipyard, which didn't have one, then you're invited to watch this build's video tour. So just listen to the music and feel like you are lying in this very bathtub with the open winged doors and looking out over the streets of Paris in the evening light. I will see you next Friday. Bye bye.